happiness and also pain and distress. So we, those who stay back, we have to go through the pain of separation, and happiness is that he has entered into his eternal place. So he is eternally happy there, but we'll be feeling the separation from him because we will not get his association in this world. And all of you know that Maharaj is very specially dear to His Divine Grace S.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Although he joined a little late as compared to his godbrothers, he joined the movement in the year 1976. And he accepted Srila Prabhupada as a spiritual master by reading his book, Nectar of Devotion. And he went and joined Mayapur and waiting for Prabhupada to come to India. Then Prabhupada came to Kumbh Mela in Prayagraj. So devotees from Mayapur, they came to Kumbh Mela to meet Srila Prabhupada. So Bhakti Charaswami Maharaj also came in that bus. But somehow other, he could not meet Srila Prabhupada in Prayagraj. But Prabhupada was coming back, I think to Calcutta, by train. So in that train, Srila Prabhupada senior was disciples were there, but Prabhupada, when he was traveling, somehow Bhavananda Maharaj was also there. So he took Bhakti Charaswami Maharaj also with him. And Bhakti Charu Maharaj was very reluctant to meet him because he tried to meet him, but he was not, sometimes not allowed, and sometimes he was not able to take his darshan. So he felt that I am unqualified to meet His Divine Grace. So he was very reluctant to meet him. But Bhavananda Maharaj forced him. He took, grabbed his hand and just pushed him in the first class compartment. Prabhupada was traveling. And Maharaj offered obeisances. And Prabhupada told him, please come and sit next to me. So that time Tamal Krishna Maharaj was there, Bhavananda Maharaj was there, Jayapataka Maharaj also there. So he was reluctant to sit next to Prabhupada, but Prabhupada told him, no, sit down here. So at the first meeting, Prabhupada told directly, so I want you to translate my books into Bengali. So by that we can understand that their relationship is very deep and we should not take him as like other disciples. So their relationship is something exceptional. And Maharaj was explaining how he was very reluctant to tell Prabhupada to give him initiation. So one day he thought that I'll ask him today. So he entered into Prabhupada's room and Prabhupada asked him, what do you want? So Bhakti Charu Maharaj said, Prabhupada, will you give me initiation? Because that time Prabhupada was little strict to give initiation also. Many devotees are waiting list. He said, yes, I'll give you initiation. Just Gaur Purnima is coming. In Gaur Purnima, I will give you initiation. So on Gaur Purnima, he got initiation, first initiation and second initiation together from His Divine Grace. And within 3 months, he was awarded the sunnah order of life. So I think he is the only person in only 3 months We cannot think this now in ISKCON. So in 3 months he was awarded. There are a lot of objection also. But Prabhupada understood the need, and he knew that he is the suitable candidate to carry on. So once I was discussing with Maharaj that what inspired you to dedicate like that? He said, once I was with Prabhupada at the roof of Lotus Building, and Prabhupada started telling him that enjoying senses is like the camels, they eat the blood while he takes the thorns. So he said you have done that for many lifetimes. He was telling Bhakti Charu Maharaj, at least give one life to Krishna and let's see what happens. So you have given so many lives for sense enjoyment, one life to Krishna, let's see what happens. He said, that is my inspiration to dedicate my life. And he gave me the same instruction, Maharaj, that same instruction applies to all the brahmacharis, those who want to dedicate completely for Krishna consciousness. So today he is not with us physically, but he'll be with us. When Prabhupada was very much ill, and Bhakti Charu Maharaj was the secretary, and he used to read out the letters from his disciples, and they used to say to Prabhupada, Prabhupada, we are praying to the Lord that all old age and disease should come to us, and you should become young and preach Krishna consciousness and stay with us. So that kind of letter was coming regularly, and Bhakti Charu Maharaj used to read that out to Prabhupada. It means that they are ready to die for Prabhupada. That was the dedication of his disciples. And once Bhakti Charu Maharaj was telling that some disciples are ready, whatever Prabhupada will say, if the Prabhupada says jump from the roof, they will jump. That kind of dedication they had. But Prabhupada was not accepting that proposal, and they said, I'll be happy that if you cooperate with each other after I leave. So Bhakti Charu Maharaj used to think they want to die for him, but he expects cooperation after his departure. So he was not realizing the importance of this statement of Prabhupada. Then when after Prabhupada left, you know that many of his followers left ISKCON. Then Bhakti Charu Maharaj realized that in Kali Yuga, giving life is easier than to stay together and push on the movement. That's why Prabhupada said, I don't need your life. I want you to cooperate and stay together. That is more important. So it's a very interesting point I heard today. And Maharaj had a style. He was so humble. Prabhupada used to say, I heard from some of his godbrother, whenever he was a servant and used to cook and come regularly to his room, no? Generally, when he come to a spiritual master, he should offer obeisances and chant his pranam mantra, which is audible to the spiritual master. That is the etiquette. But when someone serves regularly, every time you don't do that. You should do whenever you see your guru. But a servant always sees guru. So generally they don't do. But Bhakti Charu Maharaj, whenever he will enter into his room, he will offer dandavas and chant pranam mantra of Prabhupada loudly. And Prabhupada said, you don't need to do all the time. So he was so particular about offering his respect to his guru. So he's very, very cultured, and he's the embodiment of Vaishnava etiquette.